absolutely false and without basis.
This was Health Secretary Francisco Duque III's response to Foreign Affairs Secretary Teodoro Locsin Jr.'s tweet, claiming the Philippines again dropped the ball, this time on the procurement of 50 million syringes from the United States. Duque says Locsin's tweet was devoid of details, but there was a company that initially wanted to participate in the bidding, then backed out after confirming with the agency that the approved budget for the contract is pegged at 119.5 million pesos, or more than 2 pesos per syringe.
When we gave him all the information how he can go about supplying said syringes, in the end, I have the documents to show that he said that the approved budget for the contract, which is in the amount of 119,500,000, is too low, and they cannot participate if that is the approved budget for contract.
Duque adds it would be illegal to adjust the contract price set by the Bids and Awards Committee just because a bidder cannot meet it.
Ito daw mababa yung approved budget. Samantalang bumili na kami for the 0.5 ml syringes at 2.38 pesos per piece, okay? So what are they talking about? Why will I allow the DOH to agree to a higher approved budget contract? That is in violation of RA 9184, and a potential case of anti-graft can be filed if we allow ourselves to be influenced by others.
Vaccine Czar Secretary Carlito Galvez Jr. and Presidential Advisor for COVID-19 Response Secretary Vince Dizon also supported Duque's defense against Locsin's tweet.
Wala tayong napabaya.
Meron tayong 44 million na pinaprocure sa UNICEF. In fact, yung ano natin doon, yung ating problema, it's not the procurement, but more on the delivery. Considering that sinabi nga natin na ng WHO, na yung mga syringes natin talaga is talagang globally may acute shortage tayo. Pero yung proseso ng ano natin, yung tinatawag nating procurement, I believe nasa ano na yun nasa UNICEF na yung bole. And then meron naman tayong tinatawag na alternative syringes.
Kailangan lang syempre yung proseso masusunod. No? Hindi naman tayo pwedeng mag-procure ng basta-basta lang.
The National Task Force Against COVID-19 says, despite the global shortage of syringes for Pfizer's COVID vaccine, the country has supply of alternative syringes and that it won't be a problem during the second phase of the national COVID vaccination drive on December 15th to 17th.
Wala tayong kulang na vaccine at sufficient din yung ating mga ancillary supplies kasama na ang syringes para sa vaccination days this week and until the end of the year.
Of the target 77 million Filipinos, or 70% of the population, over 41 million have been fully vaccinated against COVID-19, while 54.7 million received their first dose. The Food and Drug Administration, meanwhile, allayed concerns on the safety and efficacy of COVID vaccines with extended shelf life.
Kapag ini-extend po ang shelf life, halimbawa, mas tumatagal na yung mga bakuna, tas tinitesting at naipakita na useful pa sila, pag meron po talagang data to show na useful pa sila after 6 months, for example, pwede nating i-extend yung shelf life.
The Department of Health targets to jab 7 million individuals during the 3-day massive COVID vaccination drive this week, but the National Task Force Against COVID-19 is optimistic it can go as high as up to 9 million. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.